Have you ever gone shopping in the market? You obviously would have. Let's say you go to a general store. What you do is you give him money and you buy stuff. Let's say you want chocolates. Does the shopkeeper give you chocolates free of cost? Or has this ever been a case wherein you are paying money to the shopkeeper but asking nothing in return? You don't want anything against those money or rupees that you've paid him. Has this ever been a case? This can never be the case. We generally don't give money to anybody, or nobody gives us stuff for free. There's always a price attached to everything. To get something, we have to give something. And this is what consideration is all about. Consideration is something for something. Consideration is something in return. When you give 10 rupees to the shopkeeper, he gives you a chocolate. So you pay him 10 rupees and you get a chocolate in return. At the same time, the shopkeeper gets 10 rupees and gives a chocolate in return. So both of the parties get something and both of the parties give something. Now, in this case, can you tell me what is the consideration for you? If you give 10 rupees and get a Dairy Milk chocolate from the shopkeeper, what is the consideration for you? The consideration for you in this case is the chocolate, because you are paying something and what you are getting in return is consideration. At the same time, the shopkeeper is again giving something. And what he is getting in return is consideration for him. And what is he getting? He is getting 10 rupees. So, in all contracts, both the parties give something and in return get something. So, what they get is consideration for them. So, this is how generally we try to explain consideration. However, let's study how law or the Indian Contract Act 1872 defines consideration. As per section 2D, it has been defined as when at the desire of the promisor, I'll just underline it, when at the desire of the promisor, promisee or any other person has done or abstained from doing, or does or abstains from doing, or promises to do or abstain from doing something, such an act or abstinence or promise is called consideration for the promise. Now, prima facie, at the first look, this definition looks very puzzling, because you can see that the sentences are repeating. When at the desire of the promisor, the promisee or any other person has done or abstained from doing, or does or abstains from doing, or promises to do or abstain from doing something. We are repeating it. But the meaning is very simple. Let's start from the beginning. When at the desire of the promisor. Now, please understand that in every contract, there are two parties. One gives something, the other gets something. In every contract, there are two parties. And both the parties do the contract. Now let's take an example. A and B. A enters into a contract with B wherein A will buy a shirt from B and pay 1000 rupees against it. So what we'll do is, he'll get a shirt, B will give A a shirt, and A in turn will get rupees 1000. Now in this case, we can see that A went to B's shop, he asked for a shirt and in turn paid money to him. So we can say A is the offerer because he is offering to buy a shirt. He is saying D, he is telling to B that I want your shirt and against it I will pay you 1000 rupees. And what does B do here? B accepts his offer. So he becomes the offeree or acceptor. Now please remember that when any person, A in our case, makes an offer, he becomes the offerer, the counterparty, that is B in our case, becomes the offeree. And when B accepts, his position elevates and he becomes an acceptor because now he has accepted the proposal or the offer. So A is the offerer, B is the offeree or the acceptor. Now can you tell me who is the promiser and who is the promisee in this case? Normally students say A is the promiser and B is the promisee because it rhymes with offerer and offeree. Offerer becomes the promiser, offeree becomes the promisee. But in this case, I would like you to revisit the definition of agreement. What is an agreement? Agreement is when there are a set of promises which form consideration for each other. A promise or a set of promises forming consideration for each other makes an agreement. Now in this case, can you see that there are a set of promises? Yes, there are a set of promises. A is promising to B to pay 1000 rupees. At the same time, B is promising to pay, or rather B is promising to give A one shirt. So both are promising something with the other person. A makes a promise with B, at the same time B makes the promise. So in this case, we have a set of promises. So half of the definition of agreement is done because we have a set of promises here. The second half says these set of promises should form consideration for each other. Now the A's promise, that is where A promises to B that he'll pay 1000 to B, is what B is receiving. So I can say that B is getting something in return. Something in return means that he is giving something and he is getting something. At the same time, when B is giving something, that is he is giving a shirt to A, A is also getting something, A is getting a shirt. So a set of promises is forming consideration. The promise of A is consideration for B, and the promise of B is consideration for A. So what happens is, in this case, we have two sets of promises, or rather two promises. First, which is made by A. Second, which is made by B. The promise made by A is this one, wherein he is promising to give him 1000 rupees. So A becomes promisor for this case. So A becomes promisor here. And since A becomes promisor, B becomes promisee. A is the promisor, B is the promisee. But for which leg? The first part, or the first leg of the transaction, wherein A is offering to B to give him 1000 rupees. A is promising to B that I will give you 1000 rupees. So he is promising, so he becomes the promisor. As was the case in offer and offeree. A was offering, so he became the offerer. Likewise, A is promising, so he becomes the promisor. And B becomes the promisee, who is receiving the promise. A is making the promise, B is the beneficiary. He is receiving the benefit of the promise. Now, the first leg of the transaction is done. Now, let's take a look at the second leg. The second leg is this leg, wherein B promises to give A the shirt. Now, for this leg, B becomes the promisor. And A, for this leg, becomes the promisee. Please understand, in every contract, one party plays a double role. He is a promisor as well as the promisee himself. Because he is giving something, and in return, he is getting something. So when he is given, when he is giving something, he becomes the promisor. When he is getting something, he becomes the promisee. So for the first part, which has been shown in green, A is the promisor, B is the promisee. For the second part, B is the promisor, A becomes the promisee. Now, let's take a look at the definition. When, at the desire of the promisor, the promisee or any other person has done or abstained from doing, or does or abstains from doing, or promises to do or abstain from doing something, such an act or abstinence or promise is called consideration for the promise. So please understand, consideration always begins at the desire of the promisor. Here, A is the promisor first. He promises to give 1000. So what is the consideration for him? Shirt is the consideration. So I can say the consideration, which is the shirt, is the desire of the promisor. Promisor wants the shirt. And who will give him the shirt? B will give him the shirt. So he is the promisee. So when at the desire of the promisor, the promisee or any other person has done something or abstains to do something. Now in this case, B does something for A. B is doing something for A. Isn't it? A is giving B 1000 rupees because A wants a shirt. So now B is doing something for A. He is giving him the shirt. And this shirt is nothing but consideration for A. Or, in other words, I should say, the shirt is consideration for the promise made by A. Because when A is promising to give 1000 rupees, what he is getting in return is a shirt. So, the consideration for the promise made by A is a shirt. And this is what has been given. When at the desire of the promiser, the promisee or any other person has done something. The promiser wants the shirt here. The promisee is doing something, that he is giving him the shirt. Now the important thing here is promisee or any other person. It is immaterial. It is immaterial as to who is giving the shirt to A. Let's say A gives B rupees 1000 and B does not give him the shirt, but his employee gives him the shirt, or his agent gives him the shirt, or B's friend gives him the shirt. A is least bothered. A is least concerned. Why is A least concerned? Because he wants a shirt. So B gives him the shirt, or his agent gives him the shirt, or his employee or his son gives him the shirt, or his friend gives him the shirt. It's not a matter of concern for A. A wants a shirt. So what A wants, the consideration starts there. When at the desire of the promiser, the promisee or any other person has done something or abstained from doing. Now this phrase we have already covered when we were doing the definition of offer. While we were studying offer, we said when one person is willing to do something for the other, or he is refraining himself from doing, he is stopping himself from doing, he is abstaining from doing something. So it will always be used together. You either do something or stop yourself from doing something. So abstinence means, abstaining means stopping yourself from doing. You do something for the other, or just because of the other, you are stopping yourself from doing something. So when you are stopping yourself from doing something because of the other, that is also, in effect, you are doing something for the other. That works in that fashion. So, doing and not doing will always be used together in contract. So, when you do something for him or when you abstain from doing. Again, in this phrase, you can see the tense. Has done something or abstained. Done and abstained. Past tense is used. So here I can say past tense has been used. Again, if you read ahead, does or abstains. Here you can see present tense has been used. You go still ahead, you see promises to do or abstain from. Now he's not done something, he's not doing something, but what is he doing? He is promising to do. That means he'll do it in future. So here future tense has been used. Future tense has been used. So same thing has been repeated. When at the desire of the promiser, the promisee or any other person has done or abstained, that is in the past he has done or he is doing currently, that is in the present, or he will do it in future. So all the three tenses are covered here. Such an act, what he is doing, or abstinence, what he is stopping himself from doing. Act and abstinence will always go together. Or promise. This promise refers to the future promise that he is making. What he has done or what he is doing, it is with the reference of act here. What he is not done in the past or what he is currently stopping himself from doing, that refers to abstinence here. And this promise is for future. The future promise that he is making. So such an act or abstinence or promise that he has made is called consideration for the promise. Now this promise is his promise, is A's promise. What is consideration for him? Shirt is consideration for him. But shirt is consideration for his promise. And what was his promise? His promise was giving or paying 1000 rupees. So this promise refers to consideration of promisee. Whereas this promise refers to the promise to do in future that I've just explained. So don't get confused between these two promises. In short, if I tell you consideration is something in return, something for something. When one person does something for the other, what he gets in return is consideration. Okay, let's move ahead.